So he walks up to me and tries to pull out the sword, like that. What you can forget is try to hold the sword with the thumb. The thumb was usually here on the tsuba, on the handguard. You cannot stop him. But what you can do, you push. You don't resist, you push. Here I was pushing towards his left hand, and I give him a Urashto. I just push his chest. We have that in also in our boxing techniques like that. So it's very similar from the movement. So we go here with a push and then we release the handle and use the sword. Push. And I punch the hand, the thumb. And then I cut. And then I do a Soto Murashidori, also a nice possibility. Once more. Urashito, and I go here to the side and do a classical Soto Mawashidori. Also possible, not more like a Uchi So I push him, go outside, and cut. Then we do the Uchi Mawashidori. And I go here, for example, to a Uratakiyori or to a Yahasugake. And these are all typical hand release techniques. That's why my students learn that in the beginning. So I just go with him. I don't resist. And I come, for example, to such a joint lock on the wrist again. So I come from up or I come from under and can start to use a lock, a joint lock, or just use the leverage of the handle. What about the second hand? Maybe he tries to hit me and I come to a Koshadori together with the sword. This is more advanced. And I just do a block, come to such joint lock, and can punish him. So now they have some ideas for the training, or I try something like that. So I go with the sword out of the belt and use the sword in its complete length. Or I come to here and go to the side. So now I come from under, come to a Yahasugake again. We show it from the other side. So I try down and I go up and come to the Yahasugake. The sword is pointing towards his middle line, and that's how the joint lock is working. Or I try something like that. Then we had this kind of approach. So maybe I come here to a Omote Onikudaki from under. Also, Ura Onikudaki would be possible. Or I lose him and I just push and again use the sword. Yeah, maybe I get him, maybe not. But the sword is free and I can use it. He's pulling, I go with him. This was the first approach. And maybe I punch him in the same time and I go to the side, break his balance, punch his hand. And release the sword. Yeah, this is all hand release techniques, Teotoki techniques. That's why you learn it.